hello students, myself Zainab Nalwala. I am going to discuss SS for 9th standard, lesson number 13, India, location, geological structure and physiography. This is the second part of my video. In the last part we discussed about India holding a position among the countries as a largest democracy, India is considered to be a cultural confluence because here many of the religions, even many of the subcaste coexist together. Moreover, we have also gone through the natural and man-made disasters that have taken place in India, which have contributed immensely to the development of the Indian culture. Then we discussed about India's location, its size and its area. Moreover, we also have seen the latitudinal and longitudinal extents of India. Now, in today's topic, we'll discuss about the land of India. So, land of India lies in the South Asia. Okay, in the north we have mountainous regions, and in the south we have three water bodies, huge water body, that is Bay of Bengal in the east, Arabian Sea in the west, and Indian Ocean to the south. The mountainous regions in the north are spread from west to the east, helping in commuting and trading with the another countries like Tibet and China. Moving on, India has accepted all cultural elements arrived from outside, and these have merged into Indian society. So, if you can see in this picture, India is to the south of the Asia, and below India there are maximum of water bodies located, such as Bay of Bengal, Indian Ocean, Arabian Sea. As we can see that India shares most of its boundary with the ocean, so this ocean is named after India. We'll get another picture about it. Moving on, India holds a strategic location in Eastern Hemisphere. Because of this strategic location, India also can trade with multiple countries such as East Africa, West Asia, South Asia, Southeast Asia. Okay. No country in the Indian Ocean has a long maritime boundary as India has. So because of this, India is named as, that ocean is named as Indian Ocean. Okay, as you can see, the blue highlighted part is Indian Ocean, which shares its boundary, and so it is named after our country. Moving on, now as we have many water bodies related to us, so it is very easy for us to trade using these water bodies. So this is the first picture of the opening of Suez Canal in 1869, where the ships and the steamers used to carry products and many things of India, just as crops, some silk, muslin, tobacco, etc. to Europe. Because of the Suez Canal, the distance between India to Europe was reduced for about 7,000 kilometers. Okay. This was a major help for India across the international waterways. Moving on, another sea routes connecting East and India were Sargam African Waterway, then East Southeast Asia Australia, connected by sea route to Africa and Europe. Then Canada and USA can be reached through the Indian waterways by Strait of Malacca and Pacific Ocean. So here there's a picture of Strait of Malacca, how this minor path of water was used for trading and transportation. Moving on, we have seen that India has contacts with many other countries since centuries. There has been many concepts of Upanishads, stories of Ramayana, Panchatantra, therapies, Indian numerical figures, decimal system, etc. These things of India have reached many parts of the world, and India has an important location in South Asia, as we have already seen. Moreover, there are 29 states in India, one national capital territory, that is Delhi, 6 union territories. Okay. Moving on, this is the list of union territories. Okay, where the last third is Delhi. Okay, Delhi is a national territory. Moving on, first there were only 28 states, but in 2014, 2nd June, Telangana was created from its mother state, Andhra Pradesh. First, they were merged, and later on, many of the districts attempted for a new state, and so Telangana was formed. Moving on, now we are going to study about nations which have shared common borders with India. So in the left hand side we can see Afghanistan and Pakistan. In the right hand side we can see China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Burma. In the south we have Sri Lanka. These many countries share borders, so they are known as the neighbors of India. Moving on, this is the Indira Point. Indira Point is the southernmost part of India, which was submerged in 2004. With this, few islands of Andaman Nicobar were also submerged into ocean. This is the picture of Indira Point before 2004. This is just to locate the southernmost part of India. This is not on the land or on the boundaries of India. It is near the Andaman Nicobar Island, but still it is a part of India. It is considered to be a part of India, but it was submerged in 2004. Moving on, see, here you can see the red highlighted part is the Indira Point. It is so far away in Bay of Bengal. It is so far away from India. It is in Bay of Bengal. Still, it is an Indian part. The next is the geological structure of our country. So, geological structure is a result of tectonic and crustal movements of the earth. There are many plates which used to get heated. And because of that, this radioactive process in the interior of the earth generates. Because of this, there is a asthenosphere at the very bottom. You can see in the next picture. Let's talk about this first. There are 7 major tectonic plates: Pacific plate, North American plate, South American plate, European plate, African plate, Indo-Australian plate, and Antarctic plate. At some places, these plates are drifting away from each other. So, they are known as divergent plates. See, here the orange part is asthenosphere. It is the bottom, it is at the bottom, and it is made up of which on the earth, crust of the earth floats over it. Okay? Moving on. See, there are 3 types of tectonic plate movements. The first one, when the plates are moving away from each other, they are known as divergent plates. If you can see the arrows, the white arrows, it will be very clear. Then when the plates are coming near, it is they are called convergent plates. And when the plates are moving in the opposite direction, it is known as transverse movement. So these are the 3 types of tectonic plates. Moving on, there has been a belief that thousands and millions of years ago, the shapes of the landforms were different. It was believed that India was a part of Gondwana. Okay, and this Gondwana was a very vast and ancient landmass. This landmass consisted of the present South America, Africa, Australia, and Antarctica. Moreover, it is considered to be some of the beliefs like Himalayas were emerged out of the Tethys Sea because of the Indo-Australian plate and European plate colliding with each other. The next belief were a large valley was formed to the south of the Himalaya system, where alluvial sediments were deposited by the rivers. Thus, the Ganga plain between Himalayas and southern peninsula was formed. Moreover, because of a volcanic eruption, it was believed that Arabian Sea was formed. And because of this, even the submergence of Western Ghats became more distinct. So, this was all about it. See, we can see a Tethys Sea. It is just a belief that Tethys Sea was there, out of which the Himalayas emerged. Okay. So, this is the conclusion part, where a large diversity is seen in Indian subcontinent. Even in the religious, cultural point of view, moreover, lofty mountain ranges, we have plateaus, passes, we have alluvial deposits, we have peninsular parts, coastal plains, plateaus, etc. Thus, India holds a diversified physiography. Thank you.